everyone. Thanks for joining me. Today we're going to do some really fun holiday nails. I just finished doing my left hand, so you can get a little sneak peek of what they're going to be like. And then we're going to add some holiday nail art on top. So stay tuned. So I'll just explain to you what I used to make the two colors of acrylic that I put on my nails today. I mixed Boogie Nights Lights with this Fantasy Makers Gold pigment color. You can use any pigment color that you have to custom make any color of acrylic to make really fun nails. So that is what I got when I mixed those two together. And then to get the silver, I mixed this silver chrome acrylic that I got off eBay. I ordered some like really cheap 24 color kit. And then I mixed that also with the Easy Flow Lights color. And that's what I got with this really cool silver. And then I have a cool pink acrylic and then a little bit of clear acrylic. So. Now we're just going to get started on doing this hand. So we're going to glue on our tips. And I'll probably fast forward through this because everybody knows how to do this. Just scoop these out of the way so I don't spill them again. All right, we're just gonna take the shine off of the nail tip. I'm just gonna use my electric file. They're clear tips, so we don't really need to blend where it meets the nail. Everything is harder to do with long nails, so you're gonna have to go a little slower. I'm just gonna make sure that there isn't any glue stuck to my sidewalls. Pull that away. Air bubble in there. So I'm just going to put another drop of glue behind so it can penetrate down inside. Thank you. want your brush to be pretty full of liquid. It up. You want to get it as close to the cuticle line as possible without touching it. As soon as it touches it, it's going to lift. We're going to walk that acrylic all the way to the edge. Nice and tapered by the cuticle. And you can see that's where the apex is going to be, where that little hollowed out section where the nail tip meets the nail. Walk that acrylic right up to fill in that hole. A little too wet to work with. You want to dry a little bit, and then you can kind of press it and it'll scoop right up the nail plate. Walk it right up that tip. Acrylic off the nail. So just make sure that it's adhered and dried enough so that when you press into it, it actually is going up the nail plate instead of getting wiped off the nail plate. And we always check it this way, down the nail. It's nice and even. If you've watched my video about how to use reflection of light, I'm always watching where the light is reflecting off my acrylic. because you can see little dips, divots, holes, so you hardly ever have to file if you apply everything really nice and even. Build this a minute ago, so just trying to get it to the corner where I can pick it up. Press it up close to the cuticle, walk it up the sidewall. Press and pull and press and pull. Clean off your brush. Changes a little bit right about there. Looks a little hollow. So I'm just going to add a tiny bit more thickness right there. It would help if I would try and stay in frame. Thank you. skin. So here I'm going to have the same problem I can see from the reflection in that little divot. So we're just going to go ahead and add some more. Like back. Wait until you see what we're going to add to these. Oh, it'll be so pretty. Can you see all of those bumpy reflection lines? Got to smooth those out before they dry because we don't like to file. You want your application to be as perfect as possible so you don't have to hardly file at all. Huge time saver. I always say the slower you go, the faster you'll be done, because the slower you apply the acrylic, it will be perfect, and then you don't have to spend so much time filing. Lock that silver right up to the edge of the tip. If it starts to get too dry, re-wet your brush. Give it a little bit more movability, a little bit more life. Okay, now our pink. I'm using a cool pink. Now when you use glitters and heavily pigmented acrylic, you will get some residue down in your acrylic liquid. So if you go to use a color where someone's gonna mind that it's in there, you need to just grab some cotton and wipe it out.
And to adjust the shape, we're going to use clear, where the two blend. Tapered a little bit more. I'm going to put a little bit more silver. Correct. Why do I keep going out of frame? Right here. It's a little flat. We're going to use the clear. See, by looking down, it looks like it's got a divot right here. Add a little bit more clear. Correct that. Same with the middle finger. So just walk that acrylic right up to the tip. And you can see tip is popping up a little bit because my fingers are so crooked. That never really sits on them straight. My arthritis is starting to twist everything, so we kind of have to compensate. So we'll build the acrylic up a little bit for an optical illusion to make it look like it's straight. So I'm just pressing and scooting a little bit forward to pull that acrylic up the nail plate. Now we're going to use pink. I love this pink. I'm going to make sure it's really tapered at the cuticle line, and you're going to scoot it, walk it over to the edge. So now I'm looking at my reflection, and I'm looking down the nail, and I can see it's a little wobbly, like right there. So I'm gonna turn my brush this way. I'm gonna go really slow. Just use a little pressure. Okay, so now we're just gonna fix that little divot with clear where those two colors meet. I never put clear acrylic over any of my colored acrylic that I use. Except when I have to blend two colors like that so they look like they're meeting absolutely perfectly, and I don't want to overlap the colors. I was doing a color blend and I didn't find the colors overlapping. Alright. Time to file. That you don't have any acrylic touching your skin. Either side. Sometimes you might have to pull it away a little bit. Really lightly go around the cuticle. When you taper it really thin, when you file, you don't want to file it right off the nail plate. So I'm just going to rest my finger. Stuck. Now, if you don't unstick that, that's exactly the place that's going to lift. So you want to make sure that you pull that skin away. Direct line from for oils from your skin to get right up underneath the acrylic. So we really barely have to file anything at all. So whenever I file, I'm always watching where the dust goes. If the dust settles in cracks and crevices, you know it's not blended. So right there at the cuticle, I can still see dust accumulating. And so I'm gonna keep filing until I don't see any more dust. Then I know it's blended. So when it's not blended is when it lifts too. And another little secret tip, you can see it really well right here, is I filed the whole nail, except you can still see a shiny spot right there. So that's a low spot because the file is hitting everywhere else except that little low spot. So I know that I've got to keep blending and shaping until that goes away. Again, I'm watching for the dust to accumulate. That's pretty good. I'm going to go across the nail and I'm going to look in that powdery dust for any imperfections. Maybe a tiny bit right there. The two meet, and right there I can see a color variation. So I'm going to keep filing until there's no more color variation. Feel this one's stuck. Sides with the nail, the fingernail file is going to be flush with your skin. That's how you know that this part of the nail isn't going to be like bulbing over. Buffer 100, 180. The 100-180s is because if there's an imperfection that I missed while I was filing with my file, I can flip it over and use that rougher side to correct it and then flip it back over and use that.